We start the chapter. This is a new content I have downloaded from the website that is Dhanpatra & Co. That is our book publisher. They have given that is cyber safety. Okay, so what is cyber? We have discussed internet related activity. Internet is called as cyber. Okay, network. If anybody is in the network, means that's called as what? Cyber. Okay, so in this chapter, what is cyber safety? Safety, safely browsing on web. How to use the what is browser and what is the search engine? Basic definitions we are going ahead, and how we have to behave on over the web. Okay, that we are going to see. And identity protection. Okay, how to protect our identity while we are using, while we are in online. Okay, this information, I think this chapter is very much useful for you. How you want to react or how you want to behave on over the internet. Okay, so these things will be very much useful. And confidential of information. Okay. So what are all the ways we are making ourselves as a publicity and over the internet, that things we are seeing. And cyber crime, what are cyber crime, how it is happening. So whose mistake that is, these things and all we are going to see. And common social network sites, okay, networking sites we are going to see, and approximate the usage of the social networks, as of course, WhatsApp, it's not WhatsApp, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, likewise we have used many social networks now, social medias. Am I right? Are you be there? How many of you are using?
No, sir.
You are not?
Yes.
Okay. Here I have seen 16 members as joined in the class. Okay. The 16, who are all be active in the Facebook or Messenger, that is Instagram or Twitter, like this. I hope everyone. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that's good. Okay. So we people are, that's what I have said, we people are netizens, because we have always be active, either we are on WhatsApp or Facebook, but very rare to take the books. Am I right? Correct. Sir, books alone it is not, sir. Remaining things and all we are doing very properly. That is your answer? Yes, somebody said yes.
No, sir.
Okay. Let me come to the point. Okay. So this chapter, I hope you are having the book, the same content only na, in your book also. I think I want to verify, because few of them having the old edition, new edition, something else, that's what. Are we sure? This was chapter name may be vary. It is here, it has given us a 19th, but totally in our books is updated, is only 17. So you can check that cyber safety. Have you taken the book? Whether the topic is there in your class? Sorry, in your book.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, good. So let me go ahead with the topic. So what is cyber safety? The cyber safety, as you are seeing in the definition, as you are seeing in the screen, cyber safety refers to the safe and responsible use of internet. That is very important. Safe and responsible use of internet. Okay. So we are all using the internet, but how we are using, what are all the activities we are involving in the internet, whether it is we are in the safe zone or not, so these are all the questions. Okay, so it is ensuring the cyber safety, ensuring the safety and security of personal information. Okay, so how many of you not posting this? How many of you having posting often in the Instagram or Facebook or some other social media? Who are all have the habit? It's not habit, some person may be habituated. So have you seen somebody's, if you are just moving out of their town, means they will say, I am moving to this town, I am going to this city, now I am in this airport, so I am in this railway station. Likewise, they have posting. Have you all done like that? Do you done like that? No, that's good. See, we are unnecessarily, we are giving the information to the public. Whatever we are posting or whatever we are there is posting, means whatever we are giving a post or whatever we publish on over the social network is unwanted. Suppose if you want to say tell to your relatives or someone else, means better you go ahead with the WhatsApp or else make a phone call. Likewise method, if you are ghost, means that will be fine. But what we people are doing, I feel very happy. Now I am in this mall, I am in the shopping mall. Likewise we are giving it. Correct, no? So some suppose we are went to somewhere, means I'm in Lulu mall, I'm enjoying the shopping. Like this, we are giving it. So they come to know, that is who are all the hackers, all the any thieves, okay, or else any persons. any dangerous people who have eagerly waiting for our data, our information. Okay, so they will collect our information. With that, they will do whatever thing. Okay, for example, simply we are logging into the some website, we are giving our email ID in the unwanted sites. Okay, so some sites, if you are asking to download any movies, it will ask our email ID. Suppose it may ask your mobile number, at least you will ask your address or name, whatever else, any information.
Email.
Ah, correct. That is what I'm saying. Email address, like basically to ask in order to download this one, in order to download the software or movie or MP3, you have to sign in. It will ask. We have to sign in. By sign in, what are the information? First name, last name, all those things, mobile number, email ID. These are all the things.
It password.
Correct. So password we are creating. From that, they will get our all information. So from that, they will come to know, okay, this boy, for example, from the name itself, they can determine who we are. And we may think that we may give the fake address and all. Okay. But what is the thing? Our IP is completely synchronized with the system. IP, what is IP means? Our internet address, internet protocol is called as IP. Then that is having an address, set of address. Have you got it? Have you know? IP address means, do you know? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. See,
yes, sir.
We are sharing our all the details in the internet. Unwantedly, we are sharing. That's what the thing. If it is needed for something else, means okay. But what is the thing? But unwantedly, we are just publishing our details on over the internet. It is nowhere related. It is a threat for us. So that's what you are seeing. Not posing, that is a threat to anyone else's information. It is involved gaining knowledge about the possible threats. So suppose we have been to that shopping mall, or we are in the place, then they will come to know what? We are out of town. So from that, they will do whatever thing in our home. Okay, or else with our email ID, they may do whatever thing. Have you understand what I'm coming to tell? So these are all the security risks we are going ahead. Okay, so this chapter tells us how we want to be safety on over the internet. Okay, what are all the things we need to post and what are all the things we should avoid, or how it is just guiding us. How is our behavior want to be there on over the cyber? So this chapter is regarding that one. Have you understand what we are going to discuss in this chapter? Now you have, you get some idea?
Yes. Yeah.
Good. Okay, fine. So let me go ahead with the next topic. Okay, safely browsing on web. Okay, we are using a web browser. So can you say some web browser? What is browser? Can you say something? Have you used anywhere a browser?
So to find out some
to find out something, we are using browsing. That is a sorry browser. Okay, what is browser?
There.
Yes, only one boy is interacting. What about others? I'm asking the questions to everyone. What is browser? Do you have any idea? Have you used browser? Have you used browser or not in your mobile or in your computer?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What is your browser? Which browser you are using in your PC or mobile or whatever gadget?
Chrome, Google, UC.
What? I didn't get you properly. Yeah, tell me again. Google Chrome we may use. Okay. Yeah, that's what. Yeah, Chrome we may use. Or else Mozilla Firefox we may use. Yeah. Or Opera, likewise, we have a lot of browsers are there, no? So these are all the browsers. Actually, first you want to know what is browser. Browser is a software. It is enable the user to connect with the internet, connect to the internet. Have you got it? So it is just a software. It is a program. Okay, browser is nothing else. It is just a program. Okay, it's providing the connectivity to connect to the internet. Without the browser, we cannot connect to the internet. Okay, so it is just a tool, or it's a program, or it's a software which is used to getting connected with the internet. Have you got what is the definition for browser?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So this is browser, and next we are going to see if you want to search something, what are the process you will do? Can you describe it? suppose you want to search
first
about
open, sir.
For example, yeah, that's what I'm expecting.
And then you have to type, give the input.
Yeah, where you are giving the input. For example, you want to know, suppose you are going for a tour, okay? So in one place. So how will you come to know the what are the tourist places on over the certain district or certain state? Okay.
Map.
Okay. Map. This is okay. That's fine. How will you do the search? That's what I'm expecting. That is the answer I'm expecting from you. Did you get my point? What I'm asking? What about remaining people? Just be interactive. That's what the session is. This chapter is purely full of interaction only. Okay, it's not nothing to teach. It's not a programming concept. Okay, just it is a what are all things we are doing on over the real time. That's what we are going to discuss. Okay. So how will you browse?
Sir, you have to give the what you have to browse means you have to type suppose in the browser.
Suppose we need to open any browser, no? We need to open any browser, likewise Google Chrome. Or Mozilla Firefox, something else we have to open, correct? Then next, where we are giving this input? Suppose you are going for tourists, or you want to know what are the tourist places in the some other countries. Okay, suppose you are visiting. That means, how will you do the search? How will you do search?
So search in search engine.
That's what. That is the exact answer. Very good. Nicely you have said. That is, we have to search on over the search engine. Okay. So browser, it is a program. I have already said what is web browser or else browser. It is just a program or software which is enable us to connect to the internet. Have you got it? This is browser or web browser. Okay. What is search engine? That's what I am coming to tell. Next point is this watch. Okay. So what is search engine means? This is the tool. It's a program. It is in on over the web. Okay, so this is a tool which is used to search regarding anything. Okay, suppose what are the search engines we might use, or often which search engine you might use. Suppose we don't know something else, what we will do? What we are saying, the common terminology, just to Google it, we are getting this information. Likewise, we are saying, no, correct? Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that's what. So Google it means, what does it mean? It's just for colloquial work, but actually Google is what? What is Google? Of course, it's a corporation, that is different one. But what I am expecting, we are using Google, no? For example, I'm just opening the Chrome. Let you see this. Just a minute, it will get open. I think it will take some time, I think so. Okay. 1 minute, it will get open. Okay, suppose the page has opened, we will just immediately taken to the Google webs, Google things. As you're seeing in the screen, no? This is what? Search Google or type a URL. It's asking, no? So this is called what? Search engine. This Google is called as what? Search engine. Okay, like this, many search engines are there. One of the search engine is one of the topmost search engine in world. That is what? Google, correct? That's what we are often saying is what? Just to Google it, we are getting it. Okay, so Google, not only the Google is search engine, we have another search engine, Yahoo, Bing. Have you seen Bing.com and all? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Bing, sorry. Bing.com, likewise, we are just opening, no? Okay, and then this is one of the search engine, another search engine. Okay, suppose Bing is another one search engine, and here you can search. Whatever you like to search, you can search it. This is the Microsoft Bing, or as the MSN, we are getting it, and Yahoo Mail, you know, Yahoo search engine also there. Likewise, the n number of search engines are over the across the web. Okay, so but mostly we are using Google as a one of the default search. Okay, this was the content I'm coming to tell. So that will be fine. So you came to know what is web browser and what is search engine. Have you got some clarity? What is the difference between web browser and search engine? Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that's fine. Okay, so while now we will come to the point, while we are doing it, while we are surfing on the surf means we are searching anything on the internet. some website, if you similarly, simply if you visit, means it will ask our email ID for certain purpose. Okay, so we should be very much care. That's what I can see. You need to know, I'm just highlighting, not every site is safe to visit. All the sites are not safe. It is unsafe. Okay, so because whatever thing, whatever you post or whenever we are online, it will just getting our information. Okay, so we have to go only, or else we have to visit only the confidential sites or the particular or else authenticated sites. Okay, suppose if you are visiting, you are downloading some software. Okay, if you are just to Google, it means n number of softwares or websites are there. I will show once again. I'll just go back to the Google. I'm doing the, for example, I want Windows 10. Okay. Windows 10 I need, okay, download or 64-bit download. Okay, just I'm entering, you can see. So first site where we are going, can you see this? Which website we have searched?
www.microsoft.com.
Yes, microsoft.com. This Microsoft. Is the official website, we can download the Windows 10. Okay, that was the thing. N number of fake sites also there, you can see. uwindowsworld.com. Suppose if event means it is possible, okay, the operating system is available. Whether it is a proper one means we don't know. Have you got it? So if you have download, for example, but see, you can see softplay, okay, windows10en.softonic.com. okay, these are all many websites are there, you can see this. Okay, have you come to know that? Have you understand? See, it is showing that what? A number of results, a number of pages, ask anydesk.com, python.org, downloadcenter.intel. Okay, it's for downloading for graphics. Okay, so many websites is just saying that, okay, these websites are, this software, for if you are searching for a particular software means, okay. But what we are going to learn means, we always must visit the official website. That is very important, okay. Unofficial website, if you went, what will happen, sir? If you're asking the question, means it will take to some other website. How many of you had the experience to download the new movie or movies or MP3? There is a songs. I hope everyone. Yeah, correct. So whenever we are downloading, yes, we are doing the search on over the Google or whatever search engine, it will take to some site. If you're just about to click the download, means it will take to another site. Have you seen? Again, if you're clicking the again download, means it will take to next site.
Again, it go other things.
Likewise, it is goes on. Finally, we may get download, or else it will ask some details. After that, only it will take to the download page. Okay, or some sites are there till the last. If you are doing more and more, if you are digging, means also we won't get the proper downloading page. Correct? No, it will be completely wasted. The time eating one. Correct. Some sites. Have you got it? Have you understood this? What I'm saying. So this is called redirecting. Redirecting means, suppose I am just clicking one website, but it will take to some other website. This process is called as redirecting. Automatically, the one page, there is one web page is transferring, or else it is transmitting to another web page. This is called redirecting. Automatically, this process will happen. That is called as redirecting. Have you understand what I am saying? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Say something. Only yes, sir. One five is, yeah. What about remaining? Everyone just be answer. Jay Aditya, I'm seeing now. Okay. Okay, fine. Good. So let me come to the point. This process is called as redirecting. What is redirecting? A site automatically transferred to another web page. A web page is automatically transferred to another website or another web page without user's knowledge or without user's action. We won't click it, but automatically the new page will open, or else it will take us to the new page. Have you come to know? Do you understand that now?
Yes. Hello? Sir.
This is called as redirecting. So let me come to the point again. So in order to avoid this, sir, what will happen, sir, if I just redirect to some other website, means many malicious content will be affected in our computer. What is malicious content? Harmful content. What are all the harmful content? It may contain virus, worms, Trojan horse, spyware, malware, likewise anything, a number of things are there, logical bombs, okay. Likewise, many destructive programs are available. So automatically in that site, we can get downloaded. What will happen? So sometimes spyware, if it is downloaded in our computer, means it won't show anything. It will be very fun. Okay, so it will be very fine, our computer. But what is the thing? and in the background it will collect our information and it will send to the owner who have sent the spyware. Have you got it? Literally it will spice us. Okay, what are all the things we are typing, what are all the things we are searching on internet. Okay, suppose whenever we are visiting any online transaction, if you are buying some product, the online cash on delivery means okay, otherwise it will get our information, address, mail address or phone number, okay, or else banking transaction password or something else, our Gmail, that is our mail ID, password, okay. So many informations, of course, we are giving, no, these informations and all in our web browser, no? Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So yes, we people must alert what are all the information we are giving, where we are giving the information. That is very important. The second question is very important. Okay. Suppose if the official websites, if you are giving the information, that will be fine. Suppose an unofficial website, if you have went and tried to download something, it is asking our email ID, our phone number or something else, our personal details, it is asking, means better we can come out from the website. That will be fine. That will be wise. Have you come to know that? Have you understood? So they will unknowingly or else knowingly, they are grabbing our or getting our information and they will misuse it. Definitely, that is what is the use means they will misuse. So they will, from that, suppose you are giving any mail ID, means we are started to come a number of mails. It will be junked on over our mail ID, correct? Have you understood? So we will receive a number of mails per day regarding this one. So that mails will be tempted us, okay. So or else what will think, suppose if you're giving a mobile number, means our mobile number will be traveled in some other, it will be handed over to some other person. Okay, through that we will receive a phone call or SMS. Suppose that is for our, that is our WhatsApp number, means we may receive the WhatsApp messages from that unknown persons. Correct, no? So it will be totally what? Unsafe for us. Okay. So that's what I'm coming to tell, how we want to save on over the browsing, while we are browsing on over the web. That is very, very important. Have you understood? Okay. So this cyber safety provides, it will tell us how we want to be safe and what are the information we need to give, where we need to give and whether it is necessary or not. So it will start to think and it will make us awareness where we need to give these details or how to avoid to post. For example, many people, simply they have taken one picture, they may post it immediately on Instagram. Correct? How many of you doing like that? You people are doing like that only, na? Am I right? Today I'm,
no, sir.
I'm in this place. Likewise, very good. That's fine. Suppose if you are doing like that, means are simply posting on Facebook or Insta or some other things, means what will come? They will come to know. They will get our picture. Okay. So with our picture, they will do whatever thing. Suppose if I get any one of the picture, means suppose what they will do? They will misuse our picture. For example, they may keep anything as their DP, or else they will keep as any photo as their profile, for their profile. Okay, so they will do any crime. So suppose the police is searching on over the just investigating on
it
over the
our
crime means, yeah, for example, they will see our photo, correct? So they will, while they will search on, means, oh, this is the fellow, they will send immediately to the facts to all the police station. And they will cut us if we won't do any mistake. But what is the thing? They will use our photo. From that, they will start to inquire us, at least minimum. I have seen your photo. Have you done this crime? Likewise, they will ask. Correct, no? Right or not? So they will start to investigate us. So we should be very much alert where we are giving our photo. That not only photos or even information. For example, mail ID, if you are giving, means, they may send anyone terrorist mail, okay, to any person. Oh, this is, the attack is going to happen. The mail ID is, they will use our mail ID, or else they may use our mobile number. That's all. Correct, no? We will be completed. We will be completely finished. Correct? Am I right, no? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, correct. That's what I'm coming to tell. So they will misuse our information which we have given on over the, while we are surfing on the web. Okay, so this was the thing. And then identity protection, that's what I'm saying. So while we are surfing, we should avoid while we are buying or selling some goods on over the thing, social media, we just better to avoid what? Giving our personal details. Okay, that's what. This is is not always that case through financial personal detail can use harmful like hacking, stacking, identity fraud. Identity fraud means with our identity, with our photo, with our mail ID, with our phone number, they will do the misuse. They will do something else illegally. Okay. Or they will argue, they will start to argue it. For example, have you played the before? I think 5 years back, you will come to know the Blue Whale game. Have you came to know the Blue Whale game and all? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, what are the things? They started to ask her to download. Then people are started to play. What will happen at finally? So while we are playing, they will collect our information from our phone, our contacts, our SMS, our WhatsApp, our email, everything they will collect. All the data will be in their hand. Then they will started to say what? They will threaten us. They will blackmail us. Okay. They will started to blackmailing. What they will see if you have to do. That's what many people have. They have given an order that is, they will misguided them. Okay. Go to the terrace and jump from that. Go to the second floor or third floor. They have given that. No, it was done. No, even in our Chennai. How we came this news? That is, you are aware about this or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that was the thing. Because what will happen? Okay, why should I, sir? I will uninstall, sir. Because your phone number they are having. So they will call you, they will WhatsApp you, they will send a SMS. Okay, so they know each and everything regarding you. Okay, if you are not obeying to them, why should I want to listen to you? I won't listen to you. I won't jump. I won't go to this. I won't do this. Suppose you are saying means, they will say to, see, I have your contact numbers. I know your father number, mother number, sister number, brother number, likewise your friend's number. So what they will do, they will just send a wrong SMS or wrong pictures to them. Okay. They will start to blackmail us. Have you come to know it? Have you ever about this?
Yes, sir.
See, we people want to be very much safe. Okay. So we should be either it is a boy or girl. It's we should be very much safe while we are doing anything on over the internet. Okay. So that's what I'm saying. I have said at the starting of the lesson. This is the lesson for discussing. And this is a lesson. I mean, chapter for that's what discussing. And it will create awareness. Okay. We people are computer people means we should very much alert about that. What we are using, how we are using. Okay. So how the data will be stealed from others. Okay. So these areas and all, we should know, we must very proper about it. Okay, so let me come to the point. Okay, so while we are surfing on the internet, suppose if you are doing any website means we should know whether it is protected or not. If it is not protected means we should not give any data. Okay, have you understand what I'm saying or not? Protected website,
yes, sir.
Means you can see, have you seen in the address bar, if you visit some website, it will show the log symbol. Can you see this? I'm showing that. B site information. See, the connection is secured. It's showing, no? Could you see this?
Yes, sir.
Suppose if any unprotected website, suppose if you're gone means in that site, we should not give our information. Suppose if that website is asking our details, okay. So that's what generally we should not give any details regarding our personal. Okay. That will be very fine for us. That's what we are learning it. Okay. We should protect our identity. Identity means our own originality, our original name, our mobile number, email ID, etc. All those things. Okay. So that's what they're saying. Identity theft means what is the thing? It's a type of fraud that involves using someone's. I'm reading in this point. I'm selecting now. Could you see this? Steal money or gain other benefits. Okay. Online identity theft refer to act of stealing someone's personal information, name, login details, that is credential details, or else email ID, whatever things. Okay. So they will get their our details. And with the details, what will happen? They will start to threaten, they will start to blackmail, or else they will misuse with our data. As we discuss, no, these things will happen. Have you understand what I'm coming to tell? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, good, good.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that's what good. Okay, fine. Students, this is one more minute is there. Kindly rejoin it. Rejoin if the session is in screen. Okay, rejoin it.
Yes,
so
sir.
This was the identity protection which we are using. Many ways websites are tracks you through the IP address. Our cookies are tracking. What is cookie? Let I will just discuss on the next session. Okay, so as we discussed in this last session, that is IP address. What is IP address means? It is the internet protocol address. Okay, each computer, not only computer, each device, which are all the device having IP address, sir? Suppose we are asking the question means, that is any device which can able to communicate, any device, it may be a mobile or tab or computer or whatever device which is able to communicate means, that device must have one address, that is with that address only they can able to communicate with the internet, they can connect with the internet. Okay, so that's what, as you are seeing, IP address is a unique address of your device which can, you can, which will make us to connect to the internet. Okay, whenever, for example, we are having our postal address, no, that will be unique, am I right? For example, your address is different and your
address, yes sir,
yeah, your neighbor address is different. Likewise, each device having unique address, that address is called as what? IP address. Okay, so these are all the methods they can track our website. Suppose if you commit any online fraud, suppose they have misused your name, or else they have taken some amount from the banking, okay, with their other password or using credit or debit cards means, how the cyber crime police, have you heard that cyber crime police? Have you
went? Yes, sir.
Have you visited that police station? That police station, I'm asking, cyber crime police station.
No.
Okay, fine, good. That should be okay. You should not visit, because you should not what? Don't commit crime. Don't leave others to give a space to others to commit crime on your own identity. Okay. So let me come to the point. Okay. So through the IP address, they will track our. They will track means they will trace us. Okay. From which, for example, if I taking the class, they can easily take our with my IP address of the system or this mobile, they can easily track us from which location I have taken this class, or else what I have, what are all the activities I have done. So, okay, so everything will be traced. Okay, officially it will be traced by the cyber crime police. Okay, it is one of the department. Cyber crime, actually it is one of the act we are having in all over the world, especially in the India also. We are having a law, cyber law we are having. Okay, that law, for example, IPC, you know, what is IPC? Indian Penal Code, no? So it is a criminal law, civil law, likewise is there. Likewise, cyber law also there. So anything done by any crime has done. For example, what are all the crimes may be done, sir? Suppose they may steal your information. They will defame you. Okay, for example, with your photo, they may wrongly published on over the website, okay, or else they will misuse your name. Okay, so many things are there, no? So if anything means, we have to go and give the complaint on over the cyber police, cyber branch. Okay, so they will find out the, they will trace out there where it was done, I mean by whom it was done, everything they will trace out. They will find out the people who have committed this crime, and some imprisonment and some punishment also there. I mean, punishment also defined in the cyber law. Okay, so let me come to the point. And cookies and tracking scripts. Sorry, tracing scripts or tracking scripts. What is cookies? Generally, what's in your mind? Cookies means. Can you tell?
Biscuits.
Very nice. Very nice. Nicely you have said. Cookies means biscuits. Yes, sir. Now the climate is too chill. If you are having some oven-baked biscuits, means it will be fine. Likewise, you may think. Correct? Okay, let me come to the point. Okay, so cookies means what? It is a information which has collected whenever we are visiting. Suppose I have visited, no? I have seen this. You can see. Suppose I am visiting the Microsoft.com. I am doing it, no? So the Microsoft, Windows 10, that website I'm visiting, Microsoft.com I am visiting. So whenever I'm visiting, not only me, that is everybody. If you are visiting any website, the piece of information will be get stored in our computer. The piece of information, a file is stored in our computer. That is called cookie. What is cookie means? It is a file stored in our computer itself. It's not storing in a web or something somewhere else. 1 minute. Yeah, so it is not stored in somewhere else, it is stored in our own computer only. So what will happen means, it will just store our data, what are all the activities we have done on over the website. Okay, suppose we visited Microsoft, suppose we visit the Flipkart or whatever website we are visiting, no? So that information, that activities contained, what are all the activities we have done on over the website, that basic information will be stored as a file in our computer. That file is called as cookie. Have you come to know what is cookie? Have you learned? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that's what. That's what. Okay, good. So this is called cookie. Suppose if I visited the cookie, means you can see here, you can see 33 cookies in use. What are all the cookies? Login.live, Microsoft. I have said, no, just now we are visit the Microsoft.com, no? Have you understand? Can you have you seen that I'm showing lively? So if I click the Microsoft, it will take into the cookies folder. If I click this, means it will just having some information. What are all the actions I have done? So I'm not showing, I have not done anything. So that's what I just open the site only. I may scroll down this much. That's all. Okay. So if I download certain things, the cookies files will get their information. Okay. So you can see the, what is the use of the thing? It will use, what is the use of the cookies? Are suppose you are asking the questions, it will be help us to load our web page very quickly. It will make our web page to be load very quickly. How, sir? What is the real time example? Likewise, whenever we, even though we are not connected to the internet, sometimes we may get the Google symbol. Have you seen Google search engine box? We may see it. Have you seen? Even though we are not connected to the internet, if you click the new tab, Google will be there. Google that image, the search engine image will becomes. Whenever we are doing to do the search, that time only no internet connection. That time will comes. Have you seen? Have you ever experienced in this? Hello.
Sometimes.
Sometimes. Good. Good. Okay. So sometimes, suppose if the internet is lost, means the website will shown. For example, if I cut this net, means now I cannot take you cash. That's what. Or else I will do it lively whenever you're coming. Okay, you can try with that. Even though we are, suppose if I can disconnected with the Wi-Fi, or if it is disconnected my internet connectivity, the website will be still, it is there. We can scroll down, we can see how, what basis it is showing the information, means it is based on the cookies we have. It is already stored in our computer. Have you got it? What's it mean? Say something else.
Yes, it's old.
Yeah, good. So just we come to the definition. Cookies are small pieces of information websites can store in your browser. That is in our computer, in our browser, the data will be get stored. They have a plenty of legitimate uses. Lot of, what are the use means? Whenever you have sign in, automatically the password will be get stored based on the websites. Okay. So the cookie will be, sometimes the cookie is very much useful, at many times it is very dangerous. Okay. If you are supposed to visit any website, it will ask us accept to cookies. Likewise, we have to give the accept button. Have you seen? So based on the website, we need to give. Suppose we are doing the transaction on over the internet banking, something else means that is necessary because the cookies will tracing us from what is the thing, from which location we are accessing. Correct? So some basic information is needed for the some official websites whenever we are doing some official works. Official org means the proper websites, okay, authenticated websites. Some many unauthenticated websites unwantedly get their data, okay, using your cookies. For example, let you can see real time, if you may search anything on over the YouTube, next time you are opening the YouTube, the same content which you have visited will be comes on your YouTube app only. Have you seen? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, how it is used, what are all the searches we have done on over the page that will be stored as
related only.
Correct, exactly. Recently, there is recently said that is different one. It is showing, yeah, of course, related content only it will show to us at first. Okay, for example, we may suppose we are searching for a shoes or something else on over the web page. Okay, or else anyone official website, Amazon or something else. Flipkart or some other commercial website we may search. Immediately we are getting, they started to get the mail from different websites which we never visited. Okay, so many chances are there. What is the thing? We may give the already given the permission to that site to access our cookie. So that is a spyware or else something, it will be waiting to gathering our information. This is that one. It will shows the related ad or relevant you, that is what we require. It will just targeting us. That's what I understand. So because these are the actions or activities is done because of the cookie. I understand. So we much very much useful whenever we are using the cookies. Okay. So it's not just like the biscuits what we have eat. It's not a bite. Okay. It's also a bite of information related what we have done on over the internet. Okay. So very much alert about that. Okay. From that we can easily track. We will just anybody can easily track us what we have done. Where, for example, which time we have visited the online transaction. Suppose you have done that. Your father have done any online transaction means. The cookie will be stored. Okay, so they will misuse the cookie and they will come to know when you are visiting the online transaction and what time you are doing this transaction. Next time they will send a spyware to our computer. It will literally spy us what are the passwords or username, the credentials which we are giving using on over the website. It will track us. It will just trace and then it will send the spyware will send the details to those who have sent it. Have you got it? Hello.
Yes, sir. God,
sir. Yes, sir.
I hope you literally slept, no? Isn't it? Aditya Pandey, a nice sleep? Is it so?
No.
No. Okay, have some tea and just to get refreshed. Okay, listen. Have you come to know what is the importance of cookies? I think you are eating it. Is it so?
No, sir.
No, you are listening. Shall I take like that?
Listening only, sir.
Listening only. Okay, okay, fine, fine. So these are all the things. 11 standards. So these are all the things. So the cookies itself, we had the many types of parties of cookies. First party cookie and third party cookies. What is first party cookie means? The own websites need some information. For example, we have visited the Google. It needs some cookies. We may visit some bank websites, okay, SBI or something else. It having the own cookies. That is called first party cookie. Third party cookie means, suppose we may visit some other website, that websites need all other cookies. It is totally irrelevant to the website. Have you understand what I'm saying? Hello?
Yes, sir.
So they will, that's what I'm saying. No, you can see the last line of this page. You can see third party cookies may result in unwanted advertisements on your web page. Not only web page, so that's what I have said. No, suppose you have searched on anything on over the YouTube, the same related content only it will display. Suppose anything you are searching on over the Flipkart or Amazon, next time whenever you are visiting that is okay. But totally unrelated informations will be posted or will be gained by the other websites also. Okay. Suppose you may do something search on over the Flipkart, but the same result will be published on the Amazon. Okay. Then what does it mean? I'm not saying that I'm not blaming the Amazon. What is the thing? E-commerce website. So likewise, some other websites are there. No. So they will gain over the cookie. So they will come to know what is our need. Okay. So based on our need, they will target us. Okay, this boy is needed to buy one watch. So always the watches advertisement we will get often. Have you understand? So this is the many uses also there. At the same time, what are the thing? Drawbacks also there whenever we are using the cookies. Okay, so that's what is it? Then you may ask the question, sir, what else I have to do for the cookie? We have to allow only the certain cookies only. That is certain websites only we have to allow the cookie. Okay. All the websites, if you are allowed the cookie, means it is unsafe. Okay, where we have to go, sir? Just to click the settings and you can find the things. One minute will be open. Okay. So can you understand? Cookies and other sites data. Just to click here and allow all cookies. Here I have what I have done. Can you see this? What I have done.
The third party.
So in my case, what is the thing? Block third party cookies. I have selected all those things. Or block all cookies means what will happen? All the sites, it's not recommended because some banking websites need our cookie. Okay. So better we have go with the block third party cookies. If you just block it, this means sites can use the cookie to improve your browsing experience. Like this, it will open very quickly and it will shows the personalized ad. I have said what I have done the search on over the things based on the relevant ads, the relevant content will be displayed. Okay, so it is better to avoid this, block the third party cookie or third party incognito. Okay, better we just don't give the allow all cookies. Then what is the thing, many website that is fine, some other website if you went means it will be a problem for us. Okay, have you understood this one? I've understood.
Yes, sir.
Yeah,
yes,
good.
Sir.
Okay, fine. So today we have class. We have started the website. I'm so sorry. So we have started this chapter. And what is cyber reticence, cyber safety? Okay. And how to, what is web browser and search engine? Okay. How to do be safely browse on over the web? Okay. And identity protection. How to hide our identity? Not hiding. How? What are the, if you are reveal our identity, what are the problems we are facing? Okay, that we have discussed. Okay, how the our websites are traced or tracked, okay, through the IP addresses and cookies, that we have seen. Okay, thank you students. I hope you understand this, what we have discussed. Am I right? You all understand, no? So far what we have.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Fine, dear children. Okay, remaining things and all, we will come to know that. I will discuss in the tomorrow's class. Okay, thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
1 minute. Yeah.